Hello friends, this is Gangadhar from Maths Ganga. This is another question asked in JEE Advanced 2019 Paper 1 for more than one answer type questions from the house of properties of triangles. This problem involves with the concepts of properties of triangle along with little bit knowledge of plane geometry. If you go with the question is about a non-right angle triangle whose name is PQR. They mention the sides as small PQR corresponding to the angles PQR. And it is about a median drawn from R which is meeting PQ at S. And a perpendicular from P which is meeting the side QR at E. And the point of intersection of those median and the perpendicular RS and PE is O. And again, in the question itself, we have sides P as root 3 and Q as 1. Also, radius of the circumcircle of triangle PQR is 1. With this information, we need to check which of the following given options are true. Right? So for that, initially I am going to consider a triangle PQR. Okay, we have a triangle PQR. As they mentioned, if you name the triangle as PQR and the sides opposite to PQR are small p, q and r. P is given as root 3 whereas q is given as 1. Not only p and q, the circumradius of this triangle is given as 1 in the question itself. So, see, so circumradius is usually used by the indicator with the letter R, but in this problem I am using R dash is the circumradius of the triangle and it is given as 1. See, I have two sides and circumradius. So how can I know about the triangle? How can I find the all other components of the triangle? Initially, to answer these options, I need to know completely about the components of the triangle. Means all the sides and about all the angles. Here I have only two sides along with the circumradius. Using these two sides and with the circumradius, I am trying to find the remaining side along with the angles of the triangle. See, how can we proceed with these two sides along with the circumradius? Okay, which formula, which logic and which tool we have to use to solve this triangle using two sides and the circumradius? Yes. It is obviously sine rule, because circumradius as well as sides are involved in the sine rule. So if I move with the sine rule, P by sine P is equals to Q by sine Q is equals to 2R dash. Sine rule, P by sine P is equals to Q by sine Q is equals to 2R dash. So this is the sine rule. Okay, now I will replace P and Q along with R dash with the given measurements. This P is given as root 3, whereas this Q is given as 1 and R dash is also given as 1, so this is 2. So what I have, root 3 by sine P is equals to 1 by sine Q is equals to 2. See, root 3 by sine P is 2, then what is sine P? Sine P is equals to root 3 by 2, whereas sine Q is equals to 1 by 2. Since sine P is root 3 by 2, then what you say about angle P? There are two possibilities for angle P. One is angle P may be 60 degrees, maybe 120 degrees. Sine 60 is root 3 by 2, as well as sine 120 is also root 3 by 2. But whereas coming for 1 by 2, I have two options again for angle Q. One possibility for Q is 30 degrees and the other possibility is 150 degrees. So we have two possibilities for P and two possibilities for Q, and we need to fix with one possibility. What are the possible possibilities with this? See, they may be 30, 60, they may be 60, 150, they may be 120 and 30, and they may be 120 and 150. That two possible angles for P and Q. See, if you look that in the question itself, they mentioned that the triangle PQR is non-right angle triangle. If angle P is 60, angle Q is 30, the sum is 90, so automatically R will become 90, but since it is not a right angle triangle, this first pair is not possible. This is not possible. 60-30 is not possible. Then if you move it, 60 and 150. If two angles of the triangle are 60 and 150, the sum is 210, which is more than 180. So this is also not possible. Then if you move it, 120 and 150. Again, the sum is more than 180. So this is also not possible. The only possible pair is 120 and 30. So one angle of the triangle, angle P is 120 degrees, whereas angle Q is 30 degrees. Okay, the possible angles for P and Q. Since it is 120 and this is 30, then automatically angle R is also 30, since sum of the angles of a triangle is 180. And if you look, it is very clear that these two angles are equal. So this triangle is an isosceles triangle and the sides opposite to these two angles are also equal. Since in the question they mentioned this side as 1, then automatically this side is also 1. Now, with the help of sine rule, I found all the components as well as all the sides of the triangle. Now I know completely about the triangle. This is an isosceles triangle whose angles are 120, 30 and 30 and then whose sides are root 3, 1, 1. After knowing the triangle, now I am going to verify which of the following given options are true. So again I will redraw this triangle with this measurements, right? Since an isosceles triangle, I will move with an isosceles triangle diagram. Means two sides are equal, right? So now finally what I have? I have a triangle PQR and this is 120 degrees, this is 30 degrees, this is 30 degrees, this side is root 3, this side is 1, this side is 1. If you name the triangle as PQR. Now, if you move with the question, we need to draw a median from R to meet PQ at S. So, consider the midpoint of PQ as S and join these two. This is the median. Right? And again, a perpendicular from P, which is meeting the side QR at E. So, we need to draw a perpendicular from P to meet QR at E. If you observe, this is an isosceles triangle. For this isosceles triangle, these two sides are equal and this side is the base. The perpendicular drawn onto the base also acts like a median. Is it clear? For an isosceles triangle, the perpendicular drawn onto the base also acts like a median. This is also angular bisector. Again, it acts like perpendicular bisector like that for the base only. Here, QR is the base for this isosceles triangle. Question, they mentioned that we need to draw perpendicular from P onto the base. So this perpendicular surely meets at the midpoint of this QR at E. So this is perpendicular as well as median and they mentioned this point as O. It is clear that RS is median, also PE is also median. Since these two are medians, this O acts like a centroid of the triangle. This O is centroid for this triangle. Right? Now what I am going to check? First of all, I need to find the length of RS, which is nothing but median. So length of RS is equal to median formula. Half of what it is? Square root of twice the sum of the squares of the adjacent sides minus 1 square. Right? So usually twice the sum of the squares of the adjacent side minus square of the side on which we are drawing the median. So half 2 times of root 3 square plus 2 times of 1 square minus 1 square. And if you solve it, this is half of 2 times of root 3 square. What it is? 6 plus 2 minus 1. This is 7 and this is root 7 by 2. Using the length of median formula that half to square root of 2b square plus 2c square minus a square. Usually we memorize in terms of ABC. But the problem is in terms of PQR. So usually the way to find the length of median is half square root of twice the sum of the squares of the other two sides minus square of the side on which median is drawing. So with that, I found the length of median as root 7 by 2. So this option is a correct option, right? So next I need to find out the value of OE. OE is nothing but this length. Since we mentioned this O as centroid, centroid divides this median in the ratio 2 is to 1. So first of all, find the length of median and then find the length of OE using centroid property. See, as we found the length of RS, similarly we have to find the length of median PE using half root of 2 times of the 1 square plus 2 times of the 1 square sum of the other two sides minus root 3 square, since this median is onto the side root 3. So if you calculate, so this is equals to half square root of 2 plus 2 minus 3. 4 minus 3 is 1 and this PE length is 1 by 2. Since the length of PE is 1 by 2, what about VOE? VOE is 1 third of the total length PE, because O acts like centroid, 1 third of PE. Since PE is 1 by 2, 1 by 3 into 1 by 2 is 1 by 6. The length of VOE is 1 by 6. See, here also they mentioned it as 1 by 6. So option B is also a correct option for this question. So using the length of median formula, I found these two. And again, next what I am going to find. I need to find here, what is? I need to find the radius of the incircle of the triangle. So what is the radius of the incircle of the triangle? So if you let r dash, small r dash, is the radius of the incircle of the triangle. It is usually found by delta by S. Delta is the area of the triangle, whereas S is the semi-perimeter of the triangle. So first of all, I am going to find the delta. Delta is what? Half base into height. Since this is perpendicular, if you treat this QR as the base, its area is calculated by half base into height. And this is equals to half. What is QR? QR is side P, which is root 3. And what is PE? Just we found for OE, PE is the length of median, which is 1 by 2. And we found it as root 3 by 4. So delta value is root 3 by 4. And S is the semi-perimeter. We need to add all these three sides and then half of that one. So which is 2 plus root 3 by 2. Now, R dash is delta by S. Root 3 by 4 divided by 2 plus root 3 by 2. And we need to simplify. 1, 2 will get cancelled. What I have? Root 3 by 2 times of 2 plus root 3. So this is the in radius of the given triangle PQR. But if you look here, it is of the format root 3 by 2 of 2 minus root 3. Just do rationalization. Just multiply both numerator as well as denominator with 2 minus root 3. If you do like this, then the denominator is the product of these two, which is 1. So this is root 3 by 2 of 2 minus root 3. So it is very clear that the in radius of the triangle is also root 3 by 2 of 2 minus root 3, as they mentioned in the option C. So option C is also a correct choice for this question. How we find that in radius is delta by S. First find area of triangle as root 3 by 4, then directly S is the semi-perimeter, and on simplification we have that in radius is root 3 by 2 of 2 minus root 3. So option C is also correct. Next we need to check option 4. Okay, before going to check option 4, okay, what I request you is, after this explanation, again, for every problem, again, you need to try in your own way to solve the given question. Okay, and one more thing is, you just like this video and then share this video for the interested and the needy friends in your circle. Okay, so do subscribe for the channel, and now I am going to check option 4. What is the option 4? Area of triangle SOE. Okay, so this is S. What is S? Midpoint of PQ. O is the centroid as we know, and then E is the midpoint. So we need to calculate area of this triangle SOE. Right? See this, since O is the centroid of triangle PQR, S is the midpoint of this side, E is the midpoint of this side, and if you treat a point F as midpoint of this PR, if you join this SF along with E, for this triangle also O acts like centroid. Centroid is same for the triangle formed by the midpoints of the sides of the triangle for the triangle and both. Right? So this O is centroid for SFE also. Since O is centroid for SFE, centroid divides any triangle into three equal areas. So this SOE area is 1/3 of this SFE. So I am going to find area of triangle SOE. This is 1/3 of area of triangle SFE. So I have SFE, or 1/3 of area of SFE. Now what is SFE? Since if you see S, F and E are the midpoints of the sides. Midpoints of the sides of a triangle will divide the whole triangle into 4 equal area triangles. So 1, 2, 3, 4, all these have equal areas. So this is 1/3 of, 1/4 of the triangle PQR. And this is equals to 1 by 12 times of, already we found the area of triangle PQR as root 3 by 4. And if you simplify, it will become root 3 by 48. But it is mentioned as root 3 by 12, area of triangle SOE. So this is not a correct option for this triangle, not a correct choice, right? So this is more than one answer type question. For this question, option A, B and C are the correct choices, whereas option D is the wrong choice. This is asking JEE Advanced 2019 Paper 1. Thank you.